Dear students, in our previous class, we have discussed about properties of mixture of ideal gases, and we have got the different relationship to find the gas constant, molecular weight, then internal energy, specific heat, enthalpy, entropy, etc. Okay. This we have done in our last class. Okay? We have got the relationship for the gas constant, and we have got such relations, etc. R equal to y, R a plus y, V, R e plus y, C, R c, etc. Then also molecular weight in between the two forms. First is we can write M equal to x, C, M a plus x, B, M b plus x, C, M c, etc. And then also in the form of the mole fraction. So it is M equal to 1 upon y, y, M a plus y, V, y, M b. That's by C by M, etc. Similarly, we have also got the different expression for internal energy, then enthalpy, specific heat,
entropy,
yes, and entropy also. Okay. So in our today's lecture, we will solve some numerical problems on that, because numerical problems are very, very important, and then that will clear your concept as well as different expressions we have used for the property of the ideal gas mixtures will be clear to you. So just I'm going here to take some numericals, and then we'll solve here. So this time I'm going to give you this numerical and post to you in chat box also. So I have posted this numerical in the chat box. Can you see this now? Can you see the numerical? First one is, this is a mixture of gases having 2 kg of HE and 5 kg of N2 at 30 degree centigrade and 1 bar is compressed in a reversible adiabatic process to 6 bar. You have to find first the final pressure of the constituents, second the final temperature, third the change in internal energy during the process, and the different values of Cp, Cv for the these gases are given here. Okay?
No, yes sir.
Clear? So now we will solve this question here. Okay, just I am going to solve it here. First, write down whatever is given here. Okay. So, in this question, we will see the right solution. So, whatever is given here, first you have to note down that. So, actually, 2 kg of HE. 2 kg, it is the mass of the gas, helium.
So gas, yes, sir.
Yeah. You write M HE
is equal to 2 kg.
Yeah. M is equal to 2 kg. Then, mass of the nitrogen gas, it is 5 kg. So, we will write M N2 equal to 5 kg. Then the temperature is given, which is 30 degree centigrade.
30 degree centigrade.
Actually, this is the initial temperature. So we will write T1 equal to 30 degree centigrade. It is 273 plus 30.
303.
Yeah, Kelvin. So it is 303 Kelvin. Also, pressure is also given. So that is P1. So P1.
1 bar.
1 bar.
Yes, sir.
And the another pressure after adiabatic, after compression, it is given 6 bar. So that is the final pressure. So it is P2. So you can note down P2 equal to 6 bar. 6
bar.
Other values are also given here. So we will take later. Okay. We will take these values, yes, also. Sir. Now, first you have to see here what we have to find here, the final pressure of the constituents. You have to find the final pressure of the constituents. So, as we know that from relations earlier we have discussed from the Dalton's law as well as from Amigat-Lydek law, we have got the some relation from Dalton's law. If we review the Dalton's law again, and we can see that some relation we have already got, and in general we can write pi. This pi can be written as xip.
Xip, yes sir.
In general, okay. So actually, pi is the for the ith number of gas, and p is the pressure. So here we can write for the gases he as well as the gases n2. So if we write phe equal to xhep into p. The yes, P sir. May be either P may be the P1 or P may be P2. Which whatsoever pressure we will write here, then we will get the partial pressure of that gas. And also we can write similarly PN2, partial pressure of the N2 gas. That is simply multiply the mole fraction of this gas into with the pressure.
Pressure.
We will get these. Okay. Now because the pressure is given, here it is asked. We have to find the final pressure of the constituents. Final pressure, that is P2. Okay, so here yes, we can write in place of P, we will write the P2. We will take final pressure P2 here, and partial pressure for the this gas will be P2HE as well as PN2 2. 2 means it suffix indicates here the partial pressure of nitrogen gas or hydrogen or helium gas. That is the of the final pressure. इसमें final pressure निकालने से P2 में लिखा हुआ, okay? If we write here P1, then it will become P1, okay? So this pressure P2 is given. P2 is given here. Now we have to find this xHe as well as xN2. So xN2 or xHe actually these are the mole fraction. So we can write this xHe mole. Actually this is the mole fraction. So this is the ratio of number of moles of He to the number of moles of the mixture N. Here, number
yes,
of
sir.
Moles of He. Okay. Similarly, okay. Now here one more thing, two things are also given, or you can note down here. Molecular weight. So we can write MHe. Molecular weight of this helium gas, it is 4. And molecular weight of this nitrogen gas N2, so it is 28. Clear?
Yes, sir.
Okay. So XHE we can find for the distillation. Now also, we have to write NHe, number of moles of helium gas. For that, this N can be obtained. I have already discussed in last class. There is some relation which is written as M into N into capital M. This is the relation. Mass of the gas or the mixture of or equal to the product of number of moles and molecular weight. So if we have to find this N for any gas, N which is the number of moles is the ratio of small m divided by capital M. Keep in
capital
mind.
N, yes sir.
जब भी हमें क्या है नंबर ऑफ मोल्स निकालना है तो आप मास को मॉलिक्यूलर वेट से डिवाइड कर देंगे. इट मे बी फॉर द मिक्सचर और इट मे बी फॉर एनी कॉन्स्टेंट गैस. इफ वी राइट NHe, ओके, जस्ट आई एम गोइंग टू राइट हियर. इफ वी आर राइटिंग NHe इज नंबर ऑफ मोल्स ऑफ दिस हीलियम गैस, इट विल बी इक्वल टू MHe, मास ऑफ दिस हीलियम गैस डिवाइडेड बाय इट्स मॉलिक्यूलर वेट, मींस दैट इज MHe. From this relation, okay, I am writing here for the helium gas. Now, mass of the helium gas is given. The mass of H is 2 kg. See here, the mass given is 2 kg for the helium gas. So it is 2 divided by molecular weight is 4. So it is 0.5. Number of moles of helium gas means NHE will be equal to 0.5. Is it clear or not?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Similarly, we can also find N N2, number of moles of the nitrogen gas. That is also equal to MN2 mass of nitrogen gas, and which is divided by molecular weight of the nitrogen gas, MN2. So for the nitrogen gas, the mass given is 5 kg and it is divided by 28. To get the value, this is the NN2.
0.17.
Yeah, now N is the number of moles of the mixture. We are talking about the mixture, so N is the total number of moles of the mixture, which is the sum of NHE plus NN2.
Yes, sir.
Okay, it is the sum. So you have to add these 0.5 plus 0.17. So this will give you 0.67. Okay. N is equal to 0.67. Okay. Now from this relation, now we can calculate XHE. So NHE we have got, NHE 0.5. So it is 0.5 divided by N number of moles, which we have got 0.67. So you get the value 0.67, then you will get the mole fraction of this gas. So you get the answer
0.73 74 0.73 73 74 74.
Okay, so we have got this value XHE. Similarly, we can find here also the XN2. Okay, XN2 we can also find. So XN2, this will be equal to NN2, number of moles nitrogen gas, divided
MN2
by NN2. NN2 is 0.17.
Yes, sir.
Divided by this N is same, 0.67. So find what is the answer here. Divide 0.17 by 0.67.
0.2537.
0.2537. 37. Okay.
Yes, sir.
Okay, so we have got this XN2
and XHE
equal to 0.2537. Now it is very easy. Now we can find the partial pressure. So actually we have to write here PHE. Agar hum H ke liye nikalna hai to XHE into P2. P2 is given as 6 bar. And PN2 ke liye XN2 into P2. So put the value and get the final pressure for these two gases.
Yes, sir.
Yeah, so find we have to answer. So now PHE, okay? Or you can also write P2. ऐसा लिख सकते हैं आप, एक ही बात है. P2HE equal to लिखा हुआ XHE into P2.
Cross P2.
Yeah. So XHE कितना बार आया हुआ XHE? हाँ, XHE हाँ 0.6 नहीं नहीं XHE this one 0.7374. This is XHE.
XHE.
Okay. 0.7374. Multiply by P2, so P2 is 6. Okay, so where the answer?
4.4244.
है ना?
Yes, sir.
Yeah, 424 ये आपका क्या हो जाएगा, बार, है ना?
Yes, sir.
This is P2HE. P2 मतलब final pressure रहेगा किसके लिए? Final partial pressure of the helium gas. Okay. Similarly, you calculate P2N2, final pressure of the nitrogen gas. Again, this is also XN2 into P.
Yes, sir.
XN2 is 0.2537.
Cross
it. Yeah, 0.2537 multiply by 6.
Yeah, 1.5222.
Kitna?
1.522.
Okay, 1.522 bar. So after
yes, sir,
this answer, yeah, P2. So actually, we have got here the final partial pressure of these two gases 4.424 and 1.522. If you add these two, दोनों को आप add करेंगे तो आपको value approximately 6 के आसपास आपको value मिल जाएगी, okay?
Yes sir.
Clear? So first we have got that is the final partial pressure of the constant gases. Second में दिया है आपको final temperature. Second में आपको निकालना है final temperature, है ना? तो final temperature के लिए in the B part we have to find the final temperature. So I think final temperature will be T2. That is for the mixture.
Yes, sir.
That is for the mixture. Final temperature equal to T2. ये आपके लिए find करना है. But here given is the process is the reversible adiabatic process. It is given. Process reversible adiabatic process. So for a reversible adiabatic process. For reversible adiabatic process, we can use the relation for reversible adiabatic process. So, मालूम होना चाहिए. We can write T2 by P2 to the power gamma minus 1 upon gamma, 1 upon gamma equal to T1 upon T1 to the power. Gamma minus 1 upon gamma.
1 upon gamma, yes sir.
Okay, so here then we can write T2 equal to, T2 is equal to, T1 ऐसे रहेगा, P2 को हम ले जाएंगे numerator में, so T1 into, this is P2 by P1, P2 by P1 to the power,
gamma minus 1 upon gamma. 1 upon gamma, yes sir.
T1 is known to you, P2 is known as well as P1 is known.
Yes sir, then
okay. So, but gamma is not known to you here. Actually, but gamma known nahi. Okay, so first you have to find gamma. So gamma is can be written as the ratio of Cp and Cv.
Yes sir.
So first you have to calculate Cb now. Aap kya karenge, aapko Cb nikalna aur Cp nikalna. Then you can find the gamma. Clear?
Yes,
ये निकाल लिया आपको सीबी सीबी आपको निकालना पड़ेगा. सो आपने ऑलरेडी पढ़ा हुआ है. सो अगेन फ्रॉम डाल्टन्स ला, अगेन फ्रॉम डाल्टन्स ला, आपने कुछ रिलेशन पढ़ा हुआ आपको शायद यू कैन रिमाइंड या रिवाइज करते हैं आप. इसमें आपका क्या होता है, डाल्टन में अगर आप निकालेंगे मतलब सीपी होता है, सीपी इक्वल टू आपने पढ़ा था ना बाई आई सी पी ए, बाई ए सी पी ए पढ़ा था ना.
यस सर.
या सो फ्रॉम दिस डायरेक्टली आई एम ले रहा हूँ बाई एच ई इनटू सी पी एच ई, बाई एच ई सी पी एच ई प्लस बाई एन टू सी पी एन टू इनटू सी पी एन टू. इसमें आप एक्स भी ले सकते हैं बट वो एक्स में आपका फिर के जी पर मोल केल्विन में आएगा. अगर आप बाई लेंगे तो आपका मास बेस्ड वैल्यू आएगी, है ना. ओके और कुछ नहीं.
यस सर.
तो बाई एच ही, तो इसमें बाई आपका क्या होता है, बाई आपका होता है इसमें दैट इज कॉल्ड द मास फ्रैक्शन. सी पी एच ई एंड सी बी एच ई गिवन. ऑल्सो फॉर द सी वी यू कैन राइट बाई एच ई सी बी सी बी एच ई ओके plus by n to cb n2 by n to cb n2. So actually value of cb he and cp he cb n2 cb n2 or the value are given here in the question. Question mein aapko ye sare value given hai, dekhiye aapko diye hai na cp n2 diya hai, cp he diya hai, cb n2, ye sab value diye hai. आपको यहाँ पर क्या निकालना है, आपको फाइंड करना है बाई एच ही बाई एन टू, है ना, बाई एच ही बाई एन टू निकालना है. तो बाई एच ही क्या होगा, देखिए आपको बाई मतलब क्या होता है, अगर आप बाई एच ई लिखते हैं, एच ई मतलब पड़ता है हीलियम गैस, तो ये क्या होता है मास फ्रैक्शन है. तो एम एच ई मास ऑफ मास ऑफ द हीलियम गैस, एम एच ई बाई क्या हो जाएगा, एम होगा ना.
यस सर, मास फ्रैक्शन.
या और बाई एन टू इक्वल टू हो जाएगा एम एन टू बाई एम, एम एन टू बाई M. Here, what is the M? M is the sum of these two masses. M is the mass of the parcel gas is mhe plus mn2. This is m. Okay.
Yes sir.
M will be mhe. एक आपका 2 kg दिया हुआ, दूसरा 5 kg दिया, इतने है ना?
5 kg
सही है. कितना हो गया? M equal to कितना हो गया?
7 kg.
M equal to 7 kg. Now you can write here mhe by m. So you can find here from this relation mhe 2 दिया, so 2 by 7. This is 2 by 7. Okay.
Yes sir.
And this is 5 by 7.
5 by 7.
So put the value here. By h में आपका जाएगा 2 by 7 या 5 by 7 and other values are given. So calculate CP and CB. Is it clear?
Yes sir.
हाँ, तो put the value and get the answer. Okay. तो CP निकालिए कितना आ रहा है आपका? अगर हम CP लिखते हैं तो by h आपका आ रहा है, this is 2 by 7. So लिखेंगे आप 2 by 7 into what is CPHE. So that value of CPHE given is, and this is the CPHE 5.269. Okay. 5.269 plus by n2. So this by n2 is 5 by 7 and CP n2. So the value of CP n2 is 1.049, and you can calculate CP.
Similarly, sir, 2.
This is 2 by 7, this will be common, but this CBHE, value of CBHE, this value CBHE, the value given is 0, CBHE given is 3.157, here we will write 3.157. And plus this is 5 by 7 and the value of CB and 2 is 0.744. So what is the value of CP?
So
2.254. And this ka unit will be kilojoules per kg Kelvin. Okay.
Yes sir.
And calculate the value of CB also.
Sir, 1.433
आ रहा, 42. 1.433. 4, 3, 3, 4, 2, yes. ठीक है, 3, 3 चलेगा ये. तो ये also kilojoules per kg Kelvin. So now get the value of gamma. So gamma equal to, which is CP by CV. So this is 2.254 divided by 1.433. To get the answer, what answer is coming?
1.5729.
Okay. This is 1.5729. Yeah. 1.5729. Okay, so we have got gamma. Now we calculate T2. So T2 will be equal to T1, this is 303 into 6 to the power, P2 equal is 6 to the power, gamma minus 1, so 1.5729 minus 1, which is divided by 1.5729, okay? So calculate,
yes,
the, sir. Calculate the, what is the value of T2 is coming?
Somewhat.
Yeah.
सर 5065.72 बहुत लंबा आ रहा
है. कैलकुलेट प्रॉपर्ली बटन पर एडिट करते
हैं. यस सर 5065 आ रहा
है. आंसर इज नॉट करेक्ट.
यस सर फिर
सर
687. Okay, this is the correct answer.
Yes, sir.
This is Calvin, okay?
Yes.
This is T2, okay? So T2, we have got this one, okay? T2 equal to 5.687 Kelvin.
Kelvin.
Now see, we will find the change in internal energy now. Last term is change in internal energy. So this can be written as change, that change is del Q.
Del Q.
Del U. And this can be written as, we can take capital also. Either CV dt or we can, because mass is given here. This will be written as MCV dt or MCV T2 minus T1.
Yes, sir.
So T2 and T1 are known. M is?
Yes, sir.
M is 2 plus 5, so M is 7.
7.
And the value of CB, we have got 1.433.
Yes, sir.
T2 is 581.687 minus T1 is 303. To get the answer, that is the value of DU is coming. It will be capital. You can also keep your capital U because we are taking M. So, what is the value? This will be the answer.
सर 2795.50 यस सर इतना ही आ रहा 2795.50
ओके 50
यस सर
दिस इज किलो जूल ओके बिकॉज़ वी आर यूजिंग द कैपिटल नोटेशन इट इज नॉट पर केजी मास बिकॉज़ वी हैव टेकन द मास सो इट इज ओनली इन किलो जूल ओके दिस इज द चेंज इन इंटरनल एनर्जी सो आई थिंक दिस क्वेश्चन इज ओवर ओके This question is over. Have you still any doubt in this question?
No, sir.
Okay. So now we are going to take this second question. Just I am going to post in your chat box also. Okay, so in this question, a perfect gas mixture consists of 3 kg of N2 plus and 5 kg of CO2 at a pressure of 3 bar and at a temperature of 20 degree centigrade. Okay, and we have to calculate here the mole fraction of each constituent, equivalent molecular weight of the mixture, the equivalent gas constant of the mixture, partial pressures and partial volumes. And the volume and the density of the mixture. Okay. So we will solve this question. We like the solution now. So what is the given here? First note down that 3 kg of N2 means mass is given. So this MN2 equal to
3 kg.
Okay. Then MCO2 mass of the carbon dioxide gas that is given here is
5 kg.
So definitely we can write M. M will be equal to, this is the mass of the mixture, so 3 kg plus 5 kg, so that is 8 kg. M is 8 kg. Okay. Also, yes, molecular weight we can also write. So M and 2 molecular weight of the nitrogen gas, it is 28. And
yes, sir.
Molecular weight of the CO2 gas, what is the value? कितनी वैल्यू होती है?
44.
44 है ना? 32 प्लस 12, ओके? 44. सो दिस दी आर आल्सो गिवन. देन प्रेशर इज गिवन, इट इज 3 बार. सो वी कैन राइट दिस इज प्रेशर P1 इक्वल टू 3 बार. एंड टेम्परेचर T1 इज इक्वल टू 20 डिग्री सेंटीग्रेड. सो दिस इज 273 प्लस 20, इट इज 293 केल्विन. जस्ट गो स्टेप बाय स्टेप, इट विल बी वेरी इजी टू सॉल्व एनी क्वेश्चन. ओके, सो फर्स्ट वी हैव टू फाइंड हियर द मोल फ्रैक्शन ऑफ ईच कॉन्स्टिट्यूएंट. वी हैव टू फाइंड द मोल फ्रैक्शन. ओके, सो ए पार्ट. So the mole fraction of each constituent means, first we will write it for, suppose for the N2, then we will write XN2, mole fraction of the nitrogen gas. Just keep in mind, number of moles of that gas means NN2 upon total number of moles of the mixture. Okay, it is the mole fraction. Clear? Now you have to find yourself first NN2. So NN2 you can write here. Okay. NN2 number of moles of the, so it is the ratio of mass of this gas to the molecular weight of the gas, MN2 by capital MN2. Okay, just aapko molecular number of moles nikalna hai to mass ko uske molecular weight se divide kar dijiye. Very simple. So nitrogen MN2 kitna diya hai, 3 kg divide by its molecular weight, so this is 28. Get the value of the NN2. Clear?
So 0.107.
0.107. Okay.
Yes, sir.
Okay. So we have got the NN2. Similarly, also calculate NCO2 also. NCO2 will be equal to MCO2 by capital MCO2. So this MCO2 mass is given as 5 kg divided by MCO2 44. So get the answer.
0.1136.
Okay. Yes, sir. We have got these two values. Now you write here XN2 equal to NN2 by N. So what is the N? We have got these two. So N will be equal to summation of these two. Okay. N equal to NN2. Plus NCO2, so 0.107 plus 0.1136, add these two. So what value we are getting for the N?
0.2206.
Okay. Now here XN2 by N, so this is, sorry, NN2 by N, so NN2 is 0.107. 0. This is the point actually. 107 divided by 0.2206. So what is the value of XN2 is coming?
0.4850.
0.4850. Okay.
Five. Yes, sir.
Similarly, you calculate the value of XCO2. So XCO2 equal to, again this is also same.
Yes, sir.
NCO2 by N. NCO2 by N. So NCO2 we already got. This is 0.1136 upon 0.2206. So what is the value of XCO2?
So 0.5149.
Point?
5149. Yes, sir.
Point? 5 point? No.
Nee, sir. 0.5149.
5 1. Yes, sir. 2.5149. Okay. So this is the answer for first question. Mole fraction of each constant, we have got it. Okay.
Oh yes, sir.
Second is the equivalent molecular weight of the mixture. Equivalent molecular weight. So this is in the B part. Equivalent molecular weight of the mixture. Equivalent molecular weight of the mixture. Molecular weight. And this is of the mixture. So keep in mind, अगर थोड़ा revise करेंगे तो आपको याद आएगा कि हमने भी formula निकाला था. M equal to क्या था वो XAMA plus XBMB.
Yes sir, plus dot.
XBMB और यहाँ in this case you can write here XN2 MN2.
Yes sir.
Plus X CO2
CO2 M CO2.
Here capital M is the molecular weight. आपको x एंड x यू नो ने m एंड नो ने पुट द वैल्यू एंड गेट द आंसर.
यस सर.
ओके, ये आपका इसमें मोल के फॉर्म में है. अगर आपको याद होगा इन द फॉर्म ऑफ द दिस मास फ्रैक्शन वी कैन आल्सो राइट 1 अपॉन बाय a बाय m a प्लस बाय b बाय m b एंड प्लस सो ऑन. ओके, वी कैन आल्सो यूज दिस फार्मूला फॉर ऑब्टेनिंग द वैल्यू ऑफ molecular weight. So put the value and get the answer.
Yes sir.
X and to 0.485. Okay. X and to 0.485. And M and to is 28 molecular weight of the gas nitrogen plus X CO2 is 0.5149. And molecular weight is 44. So you get the molecular weight of the mixture and calculate it.
Sir,
36.43. Sir, 38. Okay, 36.43. Not a problem.
Yes.
Actually, you should be clear with the steps. What steps you have to use? Calculation is the easy work. Anyone can do that. But you should know what are the steps, what are the formula you have to use. You should be clear with that. Okay. First thing. So we have got the molecular weight. And the next, what we have to obtain third is the equivalent gas constant of the mixture. Now we have to find equivalent gas constant of the mixture. So next term she is equivalent gas constant. Gas constant of the mixture. What is the formula for this? Keep it revising all the contents so that it will be clear to you. This is R can be written as YARA plus YBRB.
Yes, sir.
Okay, yes, the formula and so on. So here you can write R will be equal to by N2 RN2
plus Y CO2 RCO2.
Plus Y CO2 and RCO2.
RCO2. RCO2.
Okay, so I think by this mass fraction it is known to you, I think. Okay, or not known? Not known, so you can find very easily. Okay.
Oh, yes, sir, we can find.
Yeah.
Yes,
so you can write here by N2. So by N2 equal to M N2 by M. M N2 by M. M
yes, sir.
N2. What
yes,
N2? What is M N2? M N2 is 3 kg and total
yes,
M is 8 kg. So this is 3 by 8. This 3 by 8. Okay.
Yes, sir.
And,
yes, sir. 0.375.
Yeah, and 0.375. Okay. 0.375 and y CO2 equal to m CO2 by m
5 by 8.
What value is coming?
0.625.
Okay, now this value you have got, but you have to write the value of RN2 and RCO2. So we also know that आपको ये फॉर्मूला को रिमाइंड करना पड़ेगा. वी ऑल्सो नो दैट आपने फॉर्मूला लिखा था कि आर आई होता है, आर आई इक्वल टू दैट इज आर नॉट एम आई.
यस सर, आर नॉट, यस सर.
ओके, नहीं नहीं सॉरी, आर नॉट नहीं, हियर आर आर नॉट इक्वल टू आर आई एम आई. दिस इज आर आई एम आई. ओके, yeah, this formula is r not equal to, this is r not equal to r i m i. okay, this is r i m i, hai na. Or in general for mixture you can write r not equal to m into r. For the mixture molecular weight is m, r is the gas constant for the mixture, r not is the universal gas constant, and the value of r not is 8314. Okay.
Fixed value होती है sir.
Yeah, you have to write this value. Okay. So here you have to write. So this will give you, if you write R I, so R I will be equal to R naught by M I.
Oh yes sir, yes sir.
है ना? So then we will write, if we write R N two, so R N two equal to R naught by M N two.
M M M N, yes sir.
Similarly, R CO2, for the CO2 gas, this constant will be equal to R naught by M CO2. So put the value, R naught is 8314 divided by MN2. Mm-hmm. MN2 for the nitrogen gas is 28. So get the answer. Similarly, R CO2, R naught 8314 divided by R CO2 will be 44.
Yes, sir.
What are these two values? And put the value and get the value of the R.
28. Sir, 29.692.
R, yes,
sir. 29.692.
Value of R.
Yes, sir. No, sir. R N2. R N2, sir.
R N2 कितना रहा?
29.69.
Okay. R N2 आपका.
Yes, sir. R CO2 188.95.
And this is कितना बन?
88.95.
बन 88.95. Okay. So put these values here in this equation and get the answer. Okay.
Yes, sir. So
get the answer. R निकाल दीजिए आप. R equal to now by n two, by n two आपका था 0.375. Into R N two, R N two is 29.69. And plus by CO2, that is 0.625. And R CO two is coming, that is 188.95.
Sir, 229.437. R is equal to
229.437.
Sir, 22.94 R. Why 229? 22.9.
Yes, sir. 229, sir. No, sir, same hai. 229. Okay, hai na? Okay, theek hai. This is kilojoules per kg Kelvin.
Yes, lekin sir, mera 22.9 aa raha
hai. You just to check it. Actually, I think this should be correct. 229.
Okay, sir.
You just you check the calculation, not a problem. Okay. You can do it again. Okay. Then next term calculation you can do. That's not a problem. Then partial pressure and partial volume. So partial pressure again from the earlier one. For the partial pressure, देखिए, I think this was the part D. So for the partial pressure, if you write P N two, so that is X N two. or you can write y into x and 2 into p. Okay, so p is given.
Yes sir.
X and 2 हमने निकाला हुआ है.
Yes sir. Then p2
ना x and 2 यहाँ पर given है आपको. So निकाल लीजिए आपको p and 2 कितना आ रहा है. And similarly x and 2 निकाल लीजिए. ठीक है. और आप इसमें इसे निकाल सकते हैं आप. By end भी यूज कर सकते हैं आप. इसलिए you should mainly use by end to यूज कर रही है आपको. By end to into p से निकालें इसे निकाल सकते हैं. तो p into निकाल लीजिए. Similarly you can find pCO2. pCO2 equal to xCO2 into p. Okay.
p
आपका बन. लेकिन बार में three बार दिया हो तो three बार value ले लेंगे. And xCO2 is given. So how can you calculate p and 2 कितना आ रहा है. X and 2, what is the value of X and 2? And the value of X and 2 is 0.485. Okay.
0.485.
85. Sir, P and 2 is 1.45. P is 3. What is the value of P given? P is 3 bar.
Yes, sir, 3 bar.
Yeah, so
put the value. Then P and 2 is equal to 1.455.
1.455, okay.
Yes, sir.
Similarly, get the value of pCO2. So, what is the
value?
1.544. XCO2 आपको कितना दिया है? XCO2 is 0.5149.
0.5149 × 3.
Add current to the value of what you have. So we have got the value of the partial pressures.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
And partial volume kya ka value nikalna hai. So similarly, in the similar way, we can also write, isse aapne padha tha ki vi equal to xi into v.
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir. Xi into v. So v n2 equal to x n2 into v. X N2 into B.
Yes,
and B CO2 equal to
X CO2
into B.
Yes sir.
है ना, ये तो आप निकालना है. लेकिन इसके लिए आपको X N2 X CO2 मालूम है, but आपके लिए इसको complete निकालने के लिए आपको B N2 निकालना है ना. तो
yes sir.
हाँ, तो ये कैसे निकालेंगे आपको B N2 मतलब आपको निकालना है, तो ये कैसे निकालेंगे. जैसे आपको xi into v से निकालना है ना. इसके लिए आपको पहले vn2 और आपको vco2 आपको निकालना पड़ेगा. v हमारा वॉल्यूम मिक्सचर होता है. देखिए इस क्वेश्चन में क्या दिया है, वॉल्यूम एंड पार्शियल एंड पार्शियल वॉल्यूम. पार्शियल वॉल्यूम होगा vn2 होगा vco2 होगा, है ना.
Yes.
तो v कितना है, पहले आपको v निकालना पड़ेगा आपको. तो v के लिए आपको देखिए आपको मालूम होना चाहिए एक रिलेशन होता है, एक pv equal to mrt.
यस सर. यस सर. pv equal to mrt. काम हो गया है सर. क्लास की
ओके
सर, अगला क्लास का टाइम हो गया.
कोई बात नहीं, दो मिनट लेट हो जाना. तो pv equal to mrt इससे आप सॉल्व करके v निकाल लीजिए आपको, ठीक है ना. m मिक्सचर भी निकाल लीजिए. टू गेट द मिक्सचर. p आपको दिया है, r नोन है, m भी नोन है. इससे आप क्या करेंगे, भी निकालेंगे पी का. तो भी आपका निकल जाएगा. भी का वैल्यू अभी आप पुट करेंगे तो आपका ये निकल जाएगा, है ना. और ये निकालने के बाद जो आपका लास्ट रहेगा, आपको निकालना है डेंसिटी ऑफ द मिक्सचर. देखिए डेंसिटी के लिए क्या करेंगे आप, इसी से आपका निकल जाएगा. डेंसिटी लिखते हैं रो. तो डेंसिटी रो इक्वल टू क्या हो जाएगा, समेशन ऑफ रो एन टू प्लस रो सी ओ टू. रो एन टू प्लस रो सी ओ टू. तो रो इक्वल टू एक्चुअली वन अपॉन भी होता है. सो इट इज वन अपॉन भी एन टू प्लस वन अपॉन भी सी ओ
टू. यस सर.
बिकॉज रो इज इक्वल टू वन अपॉन भी. ओके, सो इन दिस वे यू कैन कैलकुलेट ऑल दिस टर्म्स आल्सो. ओके, सो दिस योर यूनिट 5 इज नाउ ओवर.